Hello.
Hello.
We're back.
Drum roll. With a brand new series.
Kirsty, help!
The market may be ever-changing.
It can't go on like this. It's ridiculous.
But with house hunting, there are always some constants.
My pad and my pen.
When did you come out of the ark?
Amazing homes.
Oh, yes.
A special house.
Interesting.
Difficult decisions.
Oh, I don't know.
Big no-no.
And moving experiences.
I'm surprised you haven't broke before now.
As always, our mission remains the same.
I magicked this.
Matching people with their perfect properties.
I love it.
You know, I think I might have got a...
You got a house?
Excellent.
This time, the Kent coast has us all at sea.
Oh, my God. It's high pressure.
It's just small still. It's just really small.
I'm very confused now, Phil.
As we struggle to hang on.
Things are selling within hours.
In a super inflated market.
There has been an offer today. Mm-hmm. There are already 13 people booked into Buick.
It will take all of our might.
Have you got other properties?
One more.
To keep control.
He's going native.
And succeed in the end.
Ooh. Location is spot on.
We're on the Kent coast, where the housing market is running faster than the tide.
I'm with a young couple who've been sailing some very stormy seas in the last year and need me to pilot them into calmer waters.
And I'm with a young go-getter who longs to live the seaside dream. But at the moment, that is a distant shore.
It is beautiful, isn't it?
It's lovely.
It's really lovely.
So pleased to be here.
I know. You're a man of Kent after all, Phil. A man of Kent.
Have you heard that somewhere before?
Yep.
Do I bang on about it a lot?
No.
I do.
Well, we may need all of your local powers of persuasion this week, Pip, because the Kent coast is one of the most desirable places to live in the UK, with house prices more than doubling in a decade.
Driven by easy commutes to the capital and increased working from home, house hunters have flooded here seeking a life by the sea, and the market is outrageously fast.
Average prices are up 26% in just 2 years. And houses cost 17 grand more than the national average. It's been a baptism of fire for this week's house hunters.
First up, Ellen, who has moved back with her folks in Hertfordshire after university in London while she searches for a flat on the Kent coast.
Margate and Ramsgate really reflect who I am as a person. There's a really thriving LGBTQ plus community. There's so many good cafes, bars, pubs, bookshops, vintage shops. The people are lovely. Every time I go there, I fall more and more in love with it.
But the love affair's on hold. At just 23, inclusion and diversity consultant Ellen may have snagged her dream job, but is yet to bag the perfect first pad. And a year living and working full-time for mum and dad's has been challenging.
I train people online and then your parent wanders in through the background. It's having been independent for so long, you know, my mum keeps trying to do my laundry and I'd really just like to do it myself.
But a 5-hour round trip to Margate makes viewing houses impossible.
Property will come online and by the time we've got down there, it's already gone. I feel really stuck and I feel like the longer I spend here, the less I feel like I'm able to grow and develop.
It's a fierce market where properties can sell within hours. And despite saving hard, mum and dad have had to step in by gifting her grandmother's inheritance.
I realise that I'm very lucky, so I'm not going to just waste it.
And this go-getter knows exactly what she wants for her £230,000.
A two-bed property, because I work from home. That's light and spacious, somewhere that I'd want to be for lots of the day. Part of that's because I'm autistic, and going outside can sometimes be really difficult. Walkable distance to amenities and to a station. I need space to store my bike, my skateboards, a bath or a space for a bath. You know, I spend more time in the bath than the kitchen. How much can I get away with in terms of purple is a question. It is very much my colour, and I think I'm looking for something that is going to be sort of my eccentric little corner of the world.
But in a market where properties are scarce and can go under offer within hours, you'll need a purple patch of your own, Pip, to pull this one off.
I'm really pleased to be house hunting. I know it quite well, and I love it. But it's going to be a tough search.
Yeah, definitely.
Because it's a really popular place. How's your own search gone?
So I've mostly been looking online. It goes so quickly.
How many flats have you got into?
One, and we put an offer in, and it went for 30 grand over. Welcome to the market.
Yeah, I know, exactly. But the first thing is actually just to be in and out of those agents
all of the time.
What are the other challenges that you've found?
So I'm autistic, and working with estate agents hasn't always been the easiest. Trying to explain how noise and light really affect me, or even my concept of spatial awareness isn't great. I find that really challenging.
Oh, absolutely here to help. Things are selling within a day. We've faced it over the last couple of weeks. How involved are mum and dad?
It's down to me, ultimately.
Okay, they're trusting you and you're trusting me.
Yeah, exactly. I grew up on the show, so I think that's why they trust you.
That's lovely. Well, I better come up to the mark.
Time for your best work, Phil. It's down to you to guide Ellen home.
For Ellen's 230 grand budget, she wants a light and bright two-bed flat to accommodate working from home.
Storage for her skateboards and bike.
In a welcoming community, close to the action and a train station. I'm searching the northeastern tip of Kent on the Thanet coastline, where the market is hot and stock is low.
While I play piggy in the middle with my couple, who are keeping it local, with a search in and around Broadstairs, where account director Sophie grew up and currently lives with Derbyshire-born Matt, who works in music events.
There's no ring.
There is no ring at this time.
We've got a baby instead.
Well, we have a most beautiful baby, and I'm sure sometime in the future there will be a ring on the finger.
So the wedding is on hold for now as they focus on securing their first home. And despite busy jobs and baby Tate arriving 3 months prematurely, they've still managed 100 viewings in a year, but none have gone their way.
We've moved out of our flat in London, put everything in storage, and the house unfortunately fell through. And 9 months later, we are still here.
Here being Sophie's mum's cosy cottage in Broadstairs.
Our bedroom is very cramped.
It just feels like we're on pause, doesn't it, in that sense?
But even though they've pushed themselves to 600 grand, they're struggling in budget-busting Broadstairs. It's made tougher by their desire to be within striking distance of town and sea.
I grew up in walking distance to a beach. It's why we've moved back down here. A garden's very important for us.
I love a barbecue, and I love to mow the lawn.
Our must-haves, at least 3 bedrooms. Parking. Storage. We need storage.
And curb appeal. So having somewhere that I'm, like, proud to live there.
Open plan. And hopefully, as our family grows, have more space for a bigger family as well one day.
The pressure to buy is on, but the search is complicated by a racing market that's pushed prices up by 13% in the year they've been looking.
Things are just going on and off the market really quick.
What we could afford 12 months ago is just not necessarily available now.
Finding a home means everything. They're desperate to get out of mum's spare room and on with their lives.
We are exhausted. We just want our own home.
I think Kirsty might tell us that maybe we're asking too much of our search.
I don't think she's going to think we're fussy. I think she's going to want to help us. I hope she wants to help us.
I always want to help, but when they've viewed so many and are still looking, I can't tread too carefully.
OK, you two have got yourself in a bit of a pickle. If you see 100 properties, pretty quickly you're going to start repeating yourself at different prices, and God knows that has happened. Mm.
We have found properties and put an offer in that's been accepted, and then for whatever reason it's fallen through.
Matt, why do you think you haven't got a house so far?
Due to how inflated all the house prices are. We're having to push our budget.
Our comfortable budget is around 450. Our absolute max is 600.
It's hard. You know the area. It's very expensive. Mm-hmm. How do you think we crack this?
It's a $100 question.
You. Please help us.
You've got to be completely honest with me about every property.
Matt and Sophie have saved hard and, coupled with a mortgage, can stretch to £600,000. But they want a spacious 3 to 4 bed house for less and are happy to do updating.
They want parking and prefer open plan living.
A garden's a must, as is walking to the beach in town.
Well,
Morning.
What are you doing?
Don't mind me. I'm just baiting my traps. I'm trying to catch lunch.
You're supposed to be catching property. He's going native.
I've set that trap nicely for us. Crab for lunch, I reckon.
I will be so impressed if you manage to catch a crab. I'll be even more impressed if we manage to find...
Find a house or two.
I know.
Market's completely crazy.
It can't go on like this.
No, it won't. It's going to be extremely difficult.
Yeah.
Things are selling within hours.
I know.
Ellen, lovely, 23. She's only seen one flat and she offered on it and it went 30 grand over the price.
I've got literally the polar opposite.
Mm.
Matt and Sophie and baby Tate,
yeah,
they've seen 100 properties.
100?
Yep. Lost two.
Doesn't that worry if someone's seen 100
yes,
and not
Yes, of course it worries me. Of course it worries me. Yep.
So they really are opposites?
Yeah, total opposites. I know.
Just like us, Kirsty.
I'm not sure I'd agree with that, Phil.
Exactly. Ellen and I are starting in Westgate-on-Sea, Margate's more subdued neighbour. But with the beach, station and high street on the doorstep, this place has it all.
Familiar with Westgate-on-Sea?
It's a drive-through. You know, I've been through it, but I haven't necessarily been in it.
You can get into Margate. It's about a 10-12 minute bicycle ride.
Yeah.
It's a really nice community. It's a top-floor flat. Happy with that?
Yeah, definitely.
Let's get on in.
Let's get in.
I think you got the location past her, Phil, and this two-storey Victorian flat is sure to impress. It's got all the space she asked for, with a lovely open-plan kitchen, dining and living space downstairs, and a light and bright bedroom.
The upstairs has a modern bathroom, with the all-important bath Ellen wants, and a spacious second bedroom, which could become her home office. It's move-in ready, and with a good old splash of purple, Ellen could really make it her own. But it's top of budget, at £230,000, and an existing offer means she may have to fight for it.
Come on in, Ellen. See what you make of this.
Ooh.
It's been on the market just over a week. There has been an offer today,
mm-hmm,
which is why I wanted to get you straight round here.
Yeah.
It's two bedrooms. It's on at 230.
Yeah. It's definitely big enough. It's a very odd-shaped room, but I think that's just me. They've got lots of very big furniture, which I think makes the room feel slightly smaller.
Agreed. So you can spot things and figure things out in terms of space.
I can if it's pointed out to me. I'd probably think that was normal size if I lay down on it.
She's already lounging on the sofa, Phil. Let's hope the bedrooms have the same appeal.
Ooh. And the second bedroom. So it's a little bit in the eaves.
Yep.
Would you work up here or would you sleep up here?
This room is lighter.
Yes.
Which says to me, have this as the office.
How does it compare with the flat that you offered on? Because it's the only other one that you've seen.
This one is much bigger. I could see myself being here longer.
Have a wander. Check out the bathroom because it has the bath.
It has
that
a bath.
You wanted.
So far, so good. But this is top of budget. And there's that offer. So Ellen has some quick thinking to do.
It's all going remarkably well. It really is. She can picture herself living here. She seems to have taken to Westgate-on-Sea, which I'm really pleased about. But the thing I'm most pleased about is that this flat is still available at the moment.
But as you and I both know, in this market, anything can happen.
It's a good start.
Good start. It might be a finish. What do you reckon Mum and Dad would feel about it?
I think she would struggle to maybe see me living here, but then I think she might struggle to see me living anywhere.
She probably wants you at home.
My heart likes this a lot, but my brain is saying, if someone has offered that, I can't compete, so I can't afford to get attached.
That's very sensible. So I should actually get in their offices and have a chat, because I'd hate to lose it for you.
Mm-hmm.
If you quite like it, we shouldn't...
Dilly-dally.
Dilly-dally.
Congratulations, Phil. Sounds like you've got a contender already. You're right to be quick-footed if you're to win the race in this speedy market.
All right, into battle.
I hope they don't mind me just dropping in.
Oh, dear, this is really touch and go. My goodness me. The offer that was made this morning was declined, so it wasn't at the asking price, but the person who made it is, this very minute, considering increasing that offer, and the agent is expecting a call in the next hour. So I've talked to her about trying to slow the process down, trying to give us a bit of time for Ellen to make decisions and for me to show her other things this morning. Whether that is possible or not, I don't know. but I'm going to develop my relationship with that agent as much as possible.
Whatever it takes, Phil. Whatever it takes.
We're on the Kent coast. I'm with Sophie, Matt and baby Tate, who really need a family home.
And I'm with Ellen, who's only 23, but mustard keen for her first home.
Oh, do you remember your first home, Phil?
Yes, I do.
Was it
Lee? We were both in Battersea.
We were both in Battersea, yeah. Yeah, yeah. We didn't know each other in those days, no.
Happy times.
After searching for almost a year, Ellen is desperate to flee the nest and start a life on her own. She was a fan of Property One.
My heart likes this a lot.
But with an offer on the table, I just hope I can hold on to it.
My couple have seen a whopping 100 properties.
Things are just going on and off the market really quick.
Which is making it hard for them to pounce on a pad. And a year on, they're still looking. So I'm excited to have found something in Broadstairs, their top spot. It's just a stroll to the high street and a skip to the sea for my family. Plus, this house delivers.
So are we okay location-wise?
Location is spot on.
Curb appeal?
Yeah, I think it's got the potential.
Ages ago, we went around the house next door.
And so you didn't make an offer on that house?
Because of the price and the layout of the upstairs.
Right, okay. Let's get in.
Cool.
So, some reservations curbside, but I think this character semi could make a great first family home in the area they love.
Downstairs has their preferred open plan living with a kitchen diner that leads onto a large garden, perfect for kids, and there's off-road parking that's perfect for parents.
Upstairs, there's a family bathroom and three bedrooms. Two doubles and a smaller room for baby Tate. Fine for now. They could extend into the loft later and create the fourth bedroom they desire. It could do with some updating, but at 75 grand under their top budget, at £525,000, there's money to do that.
This is the house that you saw, isn't it?
Yes.
Right. And it was on the market then for 525.
525.
And you thought that was too much?
Because at the time our budget was lower.
So, how much do you think this is on the market for?
The same.
Well done, Sophie. First prize to that girl. Yeah. You know the house that you made an offer on?
Yeah.
That was at
435.
Okay, so 90 grand less.
Yeah. Yeah.
So basically, is that what has happened to prices in Broadstairs in less than a year? Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's the dilemma.
It sort of knocked
it's
you
miscued
off.
Miscued our illustration
is
of the area in regards to house prices.
Is that a snooker term there, Matt? I like that.
Yeah.
Miscued.
Yeah. Yeah. It's completely thrown our vision of the area and what we can get for what at what price point.
Go and have a look at this house and then come out and tell me.
Lovely.
Let's go.
It's hard to get over the house that got away. But with such a rapid price rise, Matt and Sophie need to re-evaluate and come to terms with today's market.
This is all we've ever wanted, isn't it? Like the whole bifold door thing.
This is a lovely street. The sea's very close, it's family orientated, it's got off-street parking. It's everything they want. But it's more expensive than it was this time last year.
It's just small still. It's just really small based on the price.
Yeah. And that is really hard for Matt to get his head around. I can really see it and I can understand it. Just not sure I can help.
I can imagine myself waking up here.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
Well, Sophie's feeling it, but Matt might need convincing.
I think it's definite food for thought.
I can imagine us being there. It's just the cost of it.
It's very hard to get your head around.
It ticks a lot of boxes.
Listen, I can't ask for more than that.
Yeah.
It's a good start.
It is a good first house, Kirsty, but I think Matt might be holding out for more. Back with Ellen, and while she liked the flat in Westgate-on-Sea, there's an offer in and it's pushing budget. So I want to show her a more affordable option. We're in Ramsgate, an area she loves, with the community feel she wants, plus a short walk to station, amenities and a Royal Harbour, no less. But first, some news.
How are you feeling about yesterday's flat, then?
I think it was a really good flat. I don't necessarily think it was for me.
I've just been talking to the agent, and there has been an increase on the offer. It's still not at the asking price, yeah. But at the moment, the search goes on. I want to get you in this. In terms of the location, it's absolutely spot on.
Yeah, it's perfect. There's a lot of pride flags on the main street we were driving past, which was a good sign.
I know your heart was originally set on Ramsgate Market.
Yeah, definitely. Yesterday was somewhere that felt quite a bit older. I'm 23. I need to be kind of near things.
OK. Let's have a look inside.
It doesn't sound promising for property one, so I'm hoping even more that this modern first-floor flat is a contender. The open-plan living kitchen dining area is bigger compared to the first property, and lots of glass gives Ellen the light and airy feel she's after.
Two double bedrooms means plenty of space for work and rest, plus handy storage for her skateboards. There's even private parking for when Mum and Dad want to visit.
Despite property prices rocketing in Ramsgate, this is 40 grand under her top budget at £190,000. It could be the perfect first pad.
So up on the first floor here, we have a two-bedroom flat.
Mm-hmm.
It's a bit bigger than property one.
Yep.
But in a similar way, it's open plan.
Yep.
It's a blank canvas. It's on the market at £190,000.
Which means I can make it how I want to.
Yeah.
Spend all my money on nice paint and furniture.
Yes.
And it's where I wanted it to be.
Good. We better see some more then.
Ellen's already considering colour schemes. A good sign, I'd say.
This is the bigger of the bedrooms.
Yep. I think it's actually bigger than it seems. There's a massive wardrobe.
Yes.
As well, which is, you could do something much more efficient with that.
Yeah, you could.
I've lived in a space like this before. I could happily see myself living here again.
Have a look and take a bit of time.
If helping Ellen with a vision for a flat was key, it seems you've unlocked a great option here, Pip.
I've got to confess, coming into this search, I was worried because I knew Ellen had some challenges and I knew the market was going to be extraordinarily challenging. But actually, this is going quite well. And I'm really enjoying working with Ellen because she's very direct, she's very realistic, and she's making good decisions.
And let's hope fast decisions, Phil, because the market is red hot around here and this will be gone soon.
This is lower end of budget. Little bit dull.
Yep.
Yesterday, lots of character, top end of budget. I think we're closer here, but I wonder if there's something, a little bit more money, a little bit more pizzazz.
Let me work on that. Pickings are slim, as you know.
Yeah.
In doing so, there will be compromises somewhere. Let's find some middle ground.
Yeah.
We'll see if we can find some.
Yeah.
Well, sounds like property one is out, but property two is in. Just add the sparkle next time, and who knows what will happen. With Sophie and Matt, property one was more Sophie's cup of tea. Matt had an issue with the third bedroom, and I sense would have liked more curb appeal. So my next place improves on both. I'm also sticking to their preferred patch, Broadstairs, and heading to one of its most desirable streets. Still close to the sea, and a happy 10-minute walk to town.
I brought a friend.
Hi, lovely to meet you.
Lovely street, isn't it?
It's
a fantastic
sunny
street.
A real avenue with the trees down it. Important for Matt.
This house is for Matt.
Ooh.
Oh, okay.
Matt has an issue with the last house.
Given the number of houses they've seen, I'd say he's got more than one issue. That's beside the point.
Okay, cheeky, let's get in.
Okay,
Thank you very much.
I'm glad you're so chipper today, Phil. And I'm equally happy to have passed Matt's curb appeal test. I know this Victorian terrace may not be open plan, but it's charming throughout, with a spacious living room, fitted kitchen and dining room.
But upstairs really shines. It has the three bedrooms they want, which, unlike property one, are all doubles. There's a family bathroom, plus an attic room that's already set up as an office. Gardens front and rear complete the picture, and although it isn't private, you can park on the street.
It's up there, though, at £550,000, but that's still 50 grand under their top budget.
Are you going to tell Phil what you just told me?
We'd seen next door.
You'd seen next door. So the first house, Matt and Sophie went, oh, we looked at the house next door.
Funny that.
Well, if you see 100 houses...
Yes. What did you make of next door?
We didn't put an offer on it.
How much was it on it?
I think about 475.
And this one... you could be the bearer of happy news.
Is on at 550.
Oh. Oh, okay.
If the attic room could be advertised as a bedroom, it would cost way more than that. I'm hoping Matt can see that works to their advantage.
This house, it can't be sold as a four-bedroom house because this is not a legally habitable room.
OK.
But this is usable.
I really want my own music studio, and this would be a lovely space for that.
Does this feel bigger or smaller than the garden of the house next door?
Similar.
Right, okie doke. But, nah. No.
It's just, it's not a bad size. I just would be looking for something bigger.
I wanted to show Matt a house which had those rooms, but you've lost garden size, you've lost parking. Is it worth it?
I would say no.
We're still with house number one.
Still with house number one currently.
There's a lot more space. This property is definitely a bit of me.
Oh dear. I hope these two can get on the same page pronto.
It's nice size.
How did you get on down here?
Listen,
Sophie.
The first house, and they came out wreathed in smiles because the house was better than expected. This house has got the bedrooms that Matt thought he wanted, but the sacrifice, I think, is too great.
I just find this really strange. You walk into a room and there's a wall here. The flow just doesn't feel as natural.
Have you got other properties?
One more. I think the first one will be where we end up.
OK. How are you guys getting on? Seen enough?
We've seen enough. What do you think, Matt?
I think it's a bit of me, but I don't think it's a bit of you.
Yeah.
Ooh.
It doesn't have parking. Garden's not as big as we would maybe like. It's not worth the compromise for the money.
The bedroom thing is not enough of a gain for the loss.
Yeah.
OK. Search goes on.
No, well, house number one is in the running. Yeah.
Perhaps.
Oh, remember. don't.
No, I am. I do like
you
it. It's a maybe. It's a definite maybe.
That's definitely clear. Maybe.
I don't know whether to laugh or cry, but in this market, I'm only glad the door's not closed on property one just yet.
This time, we're searching the lovely Kent coast.
The problem is for Sophie and Matt that it's same location, same budget, different year, totally different properties.
All priced higher than a year ago. But after 12 months of searching and 100 viewings, our property one might be the one.
Ticks a lot of boxes.
It's a good start.
With Ellen, we're fighting to hang on to properties, but the East Kent coast market, even for a local boy like myself, is no pushover.
Ellen acknowledges her autism causes trouble visualising a space, but that certainly wasn't the case at property two.
But I wonder if there's something, a little bit more money, a little bit more pizzazz.
So next, I'm hoping to top it, as I'm bringing Ellen to her number one spot, trendy Margate Old Town.
The very, very hip and happening Margate Old Town. I mean, it's got everything.
Here, her budget will only stretch to a one-bed flat, but it's in the heart of where she loves to hang out and meet friends.
The flat I'm going to show you is up there.
It's a very gorgeous building.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah. I was here just a few weeks ago and was thinking how cool it would be to live exactly here. I feel more at home here than any of the spaces we've been to so far.
It does come with a compromise, yes, but we've added a lot of character. We've kept the sea, and we've absolutely trumped the lifestyle in the community.
I think I might discover work-life balance here.
You might have to. Come on.
Ellen's in love outside, Phil, and inside this one-bed penthouse, she should be just as smitten.
Internally, this place is almost the same size as property two, with large windows throughout, making it feel open and bright.
And unlike the other flats, there's a separate kitchen. And whilst only one bedroom, it's vast and could accommodate a cosy corner to work from. The bathroom even has the tub she wants.
But the location's the winner, just a stone's throw from the sea. Properties for sale here are rare, and at £210,000, it's also 20 grand under budget.
Come on in. Now, this is an amazing bedroom.
This is a huge bedroom. It's massive.
It is the only one.
Yeah. And it's actually
surprisingly quiet as well.
At this time of day, yes.
Yeah.
At night, I think it'd be quite noisy, but you are in the thick of the action.
Yeah, that's what you get.
It is on the market at £210,000.
OK.
A two-bed in Margate Old Town, it's way out of budget.
Yeah.
But you do gain a room. It's just not a bedroom.
Nicely negotiated, Phil. You've done this before.
And then this is the living room.
Yes.
With a separate kitchen.
With
so you've lost
kitchen.
A bedroom, but you've gained a kitchen.
Which I think I prefer.
Yeah.
And the kitchen's a decent size as well. I'm very confused now, Phil.
So you did want something in the middle ground.
I can see how much I fit here.
What would your mum say?
No.
Why?
Where's she going to sleep?
Airbnb around the corner.
She will hate you. Yeah, no.
Joking aside, a pull-down sofa in the lovely living room would do the job for her parents visiting.
Ellen has very fixed ideals. That's the way her brain works. That's how she operates. So me showing her one bed will throw her, and she'll find that very difficult to reconcile. So I kind of feel for her, but I'm absolutely here to help and do the best that I can. What's going through your mind?
It's a brilliant property, unbelievable location. The compromise is the one bed, it's not insurmountable.
How can I help?
I don't know.
Do you want to be out there in the old town, moving and shaking? You do, don't you? Of course you do.
I do. I really, really do. These places don't come up. I've been looking. Mm. So you're a very, very lucky, clever man. Keep that one.
I'll keep that one.
Phil, don't let it go to your head, but it does seem like you're leaving here with two properties in the running. Back with Sophie and Matt, and I've run out of broad stairs options to balance the size versus price location equation. So we're heading a mile southwest into Ramsgate, a place they would consider with the sea and amenities. Houses here are a staggering 34% cheaper, meaning lower prices and space.
Right, because it's a noisy road and it's windy, we're just going to go straight in.
Okie dokes.
And then we will have a look around the house and talk about it.
I've taken a bit of a gamble with the road. But for our space-seeking family, this detached house on a corner plot delivers.
Downstairs has a lounge, dining room, kitchen and adjacent sitting room, which could be knocked together to create the open-plan family space they want.
Upstairs is the perfect setup, with four good-sized bedrooms to divvy up and a family bathroom. The wraparound garden, garage and private parking completes the package. Price has been a sticking point. This is on at £150,000 under their top budget, at £450,000. But will it be enough to tempt Matt and Sophie out of Broadstairs?
I think Sophie's face is saying it all, Kirsty.
I can tell. I'll just talk you through where my head is at. This has got four bedrooms, and there's a garage and off-street parking, so you would never go near this road. So you'd park the car right up at the end, come into the garden, into the house, and it's on the market at £450,000, but there's one just round the corner. It's just gone under offer at £550,000.
The main road, just the area, it's not... For us, it's not what we want.
No, but it does illustrate where we are. Mm.
I'm not sure this is going to plan.
Well, this is the reality of the lower end of their budget, Phil. Something has to give on every search. Sophie and Matt need to understand what their money can buy.
That's why I think property one is quite a good compromise. That house is a little bit neglected at the moment, but not in a major way.
Mm-hmm. It is the most perfect location. It does tick all our boxes, just not the cost.
Do you want to go back to property one and have a look at it again?
We need to have a proper discussion about it. Would it help to go back to property one?
I think it potentially would help.
Let's go.
I'm glad they're open to visiting property one again, Kirsty. This search may end happily yet. Staying in Ramsgate with Ellen, and with little stock to choose from, I'm trying something different, again. A new property's come on that solves the missing bedroom at the Margate flat and could be a fantastic future-proof option.
I'm excited about this one, Ellen.
OK.
hope I'm not going to confuse you ever more. It's about a 10-minute walk to the station. It's about 8 minutes down into the harbour.
Yep.
3-minute skate, I should think.
Especially on that hill.
It's a slightly busy road on a corner next to a pub.
The location doesn't necessarily concern me.
You are the first person to see this. There are already 13 people booked in. It's a house.
It's even got a front door.
But we are not going through the front door, we're going through the back door.
Perfect.
Follow me.
And there's plenty more to distract from the noise of that road inside this four-floored house. Upstairs, unlike the Margate flat, there's no shortage of bedrooms. Three over two floors. This means a room for Ellen's home office and a spare for Mum and Dad. That'll keep them happy.
There's a lovely living room and separate kitchen on the ground floor, a private courtyard, and a two-room cellar means stacks of storage for the bike and skateboards. Moving further from the action results in the biggest house yet, but only Ellen can decide if that's worth it. It's on for 20 grand under budget at £210,000. But with 13 viewings booked, it'll go fast.
Kitchen,
yep.
Separate kitchen, but come on through. Separate living room.
Ooh. It's a very funky shape.
You have four floors, three bedrooms, plus a cellar. And there's two rooms in the cellar.
Oh, my God.
£210,000.
I think by the end of yesterday evening, I had decided that I was going to try and make an offer on that flat. And now I'm very confused. Again.
Sorry.
Being on the same price as the one bed in Margate is a lot to take in. Both could make great first homes, but this would certainly be better long term.
It would be really lovely,
yeah,
to have a separate designated office. Equally, of course, it would be lovely living in Margate Old Town, looking out the window and going, there's my friend, I'll go and have coffee.
Yeah.
In that one-bedroom flat, you were concerned about what your mum and dad would think. But now, here, they could have their own bedroom.
I think they'd quite happily buy this.
But would Ellen buy it? That's what matters here, Phil.
Ellen is trying to balance out an awful lot of things. She's got practical needs, like she works from home. But she also very much wants the right community and the right lifestyle. It's classic head versus heart, but the market's fast. It's not easy, and I wish I could do more to help, but it is entirely her call.
And with 13 potential buyers queued up at the door, I hope Ellen's ready for some swift decision-making.
I feel a lot more calm about the decision on this than I do about the other place. OK, it's in a bit of a quieter area, but that means that it can be bigger.
So there's me saying there's 13 viewings, but things do sell and go on offer on the day.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to go for it, we should go and have a think and a drink.
I think I want to, you know? I think I need to do a bit of a think, but I think I want to.
How long do you need?
To ring my mother.
Fine, no, that's good. Do that.
It's Ellen's decision in the end, Pip. But a good chat with Mum always helps.
Well, I hope she's on speed dial, because this property won't hang around.
On the Kent coast, tensions are high as Sophie and Matt are split over property one in Broadstairs.
Always good to see a house when it's not sunny.
A bit grey.
Yeah.
So we're back for a second look.
I like this house more second time, because I can see how it's actually in really good nick and it just needs some TLC.
I really like it and I can imagine us being here.
So it's on for 525.
So I would say I think I'd be comfortable just about around the 475 mark.
Sophie, if she was completely honest, would say, oh, for God's sake, just pay 525, let's get on with our life. am I wrong?
No.
No, OK. You, Matt, do not want to do it. You really passionately believe that the market is too hot at the moment. The swaying, Matt.
Yeah, the swaying.
It's anxiety, isn't it?
Very much so.
Go and have a look upstairs.
Thank you.
To be fair to Matt, the market has gone bonkers. And £525,000 is a lot of money to spend.
At what point does the room become too small?
this isn't much smaller than the room that you grew up in.
The room I grew up in.
It's not that much.
It's like two times the size of this.
Feeling helpless in this job is not uncommon. Feeling this unable to help doesn't happen that often. Part of me thinks just do it and get on with living. But the other part of me thinks, what if they're sitting here in this house and £50,000 gets wiped off the value?
There are no easy answers, but this is as close as they've come to finding what they want where they want it.
It needs a full board in.
But it's a big space?
Yeah, it's sizeable.
Long term, extending into the attic could be the solution to alleviate Matt's worries over the small third bedroom.
Okie dokie.
But will it be enough?
Whilst Matt and Sophie debate, in Ramsgate, Ellen's chatted with Mum and Dad and settled on the three-bed house on the market at £210,000. But there's a spanner in the works.
The agents are saying that the owner wants it to go to the open day on Saturday. They're also saying that they've had two offers since we were there.
With so much competition, I want to know what it would take to remove the Ramsgate house from the market today.
This is going to be tough.
Yeah.
But let me give it my shot. Happy?
Yep. I don't know how you do this as a job.
I don't either. I get nervous every time. Hello, Hannah. We feel that the house is worth about £200,000. It's got irregular shaped rooms, it's on a busy road, it's opposite a pub. However, my buyer recognises all of that. She's a brilliant buyer because she's got a 25% deposit. Is there a number that would close the door this afternoon? She'll take the house. There won't be any mucking around.
Yeah.
What's the number? Bye-bye. We're in the market.
Yeah.
You are indeed, Phil, and it's a tough enough place to be for old hands like you and me. Never mind our first-time buyers. In Broadstairs, it's decision time. Matt and Sophie were split on property one. I'm hoping they've worked out the right compromise to move things on.
There is a house which you like. Sophie arguably likes a bit more than you do, Matt, would say.
Maybe just a little bit.
A little bit more. You can't face the idea of renting, much as Sophie's mum has been amazing. Mm. That's not feasible long term, is it, Matt? Don't know why I'm laughing. It should be crying.
It's been a tough search, but it's a question of whether our front runner ticks enough boxes for both of them.
I think I would want to put an offer in the first place, but you need a bit more time, which is absolutely understandable. Just crunch some numbers.
Yeah. Okay. So we know where you are.
Mm.
Yeah.
Great.
Solved.
Solved. Drink up.
So no new home for now. But with a good option on the table, there's lots of thinking to do, especially for Matt. With Ellen, the agent has suggested £240,000 might close the door on the open day. That's 30 grand over asking and more than she can afford.
I really don't think there's any point in showing your cards now and making an offer. It'll be used against you. Let me speak with her, liaise with her on Monday, and I'll come back to you.
Yeah.
Oh. Not today. Maybe next week, but it's going to cost more than £210,000.
Good tactics, Phil, but looks like some tough negotiation awaits.
Well, it would have been Kirsty, but after sleeping on it, Ellen remembered how much she loved the one-bed flat in Margate Old Town, and we offered the full asking price of £210,000.
Ellen, are you there?
Yeah, hiya.
I spoke direct to the vendor. She's got three viewings lined up. She's expecting another one.
She is now cancelling those viewings, and the flat is yours.
Oh, my God.
I'm really, really super pleased for you.
I mean, I might just go have a small weep.
You're allowed.
I'm going to be happy.
Listen, congratulations. Lots of love.
Well done.
All the best to
you. Take care.
Bye.
I'm thrilled for Ellen. It may have taken almost a year and a helping hand from me, but what a fantastic first flat.
Five weeks later, with Sophie and Matt, there has been movement over property one in Broadstairs.
It has since dropped in value, and we're still very much in conversations.
I still have a bit of a blocker about the current price, whereas Sophie's still really keen to kind of plough ahead.
Conversations is a nice way of putting it. It's more arguments.
One thing they do agree on, even a reduction in asking price from 525 to 515 isn't quite enough.
I would like to put in a kind of cheeky official offer, but we need to both agree on it, and we don't, so.
So for now, Property One isn't for them, but at least they agree on one thing.
I think Kirsty did help us focus our search.
I am very much set on Broadstairs now, that beach lifestyle and things like that.
Broadstairs is by far the number one location.
With that kind of focus, hopefully this search will soon be at an end.
With Ellen, her purchase of the Margate flat is progressing, and although she thought her parents wouldn't like it, it was her dad who made her see it was the one for her.
I burst into tears. I was like, I think I have to put an offer in on the Margate flat, because the idea of not having it made me literally cry.
And with part of her budget coming from inheritance, choosing the right property was paramount.
My mum also knew that Granny would have been really happy to see the money go into this property that I clearly loved.
Now it's 3 months until Ellen gets her keys and she's itching to get stuck in.
I have this mild obsession with interiors that I haven't really had the opportunity to express.
The buzz of the town was a big draw for Ellen, and that seems to be lining up nicely too.
A couple of friends have recently moved to Margate, and I'm really excited that one of them is also queer and autistic. If it wasn't for Phil trusting his gut and showing me that property, I wouldn't have even looked at it. Yeah, thank you very much for putting up with me.
I think it was the other way around, Ellen. My genuine pleasure.
If you'd like help finding your next home, then we want to hear from you. You can apply online at channel4.com/takepart.